Hey folks, Landstryder here, and welcome back to episode 16 in my Regrowth series. Today, I'm going to be a little bit all over the place again. I've got some technology things to wrap up, and then I'm hoping to get into some magic and Botania and witchery stuff. And I just really can't help it too much with this pack to be all over the place, because it is kind of built that way. You kind of have to do a little of this and then go do a little of that in order to continue on in the first string of things that you're trying to get done. Anyway, let me get out of that. Anyway, I put together the power system. I've got it about halfway done, and I wanted to show it to you at this stage so that you could really see how it works before I start covering everything up with these facades. You see, I've already got a few facades in place starting to hide things in the walls and such. And the way you make those facades is you get these cobblestone structure pipes. Look at the recipe for that. It's just a cobblestone transport pipe combined with a gravel give you these structure pipes. And then you need to use those in your assembly table. And put some of those in there. It's also how you make your pipe plugs so that you can prevent things from going down certain directions. I've got a couple pipe plugs that I used to prevent the energy pipes from making loops up in there. That's how I got those that close together. Then, that's my output chest. This thing automatically attempts to eject into a nearby inventory. It can also eject into that if it's an acceptable item. So whenever I make gates, sometimes they show up over there. In the gate programmer integration table, it does more than program gates, but that's mainly what I've been using it for. So, you can see I've got a bunch of gates, all four colors of pipe wire I've been working with, and I've got some gates back in here. And that's that one is the iron gate, the next one over here is the gold gate, and this one is the diamond gate. The reason I had to make those additional gates is if we look at... Well, let me finish my original thought. I was about to show you how to make... that's me being all over the place again. I was about to show you how to make facades. So once you have your cobblestone structure pipe, you put any kind of block in here, and if it can make a facade, you can see it's making facades right there, stone facades, or brick facades. I also want some stone facades, because all this area down here is going to be either stone or brick. Now, did it finish? It did not finish. I need to make a few more stone facades. What I actually need is some more cobblestone pipe. That's what I ran out of pipe. And it's just using the energy that was in the system that was left over from last time I was using it to make all those gates that we will get to here in a second. So just make some more cobblestone. I'm going to probably be using a ton of these over, you know, the course of the series. So I might as well go ahead and just make a bunch of them. So there we go, 64 structure pipes. Come on back down in here, and if I put them back in there, you see it starts lasering. And that is, and the reason it's able to do that is because there's energy left over in the system. Did it finish? It did, in fact, finish that time. So it made me a bunch of facades. Facades don't take a lot of energy to create, so that's why I was able to do that with just the energy that it had left over from earlier. So if I was to, say, make a redstone chipset, it's going to run out of power that's in the reserves. So there it goes. It ran out of power. Didn't finish. So now I need to turn on the engines downstairs. Well, I can do that from right here. This first switch is controlling the first set of bank of engines I have down here. And what I decided to do is I'm actually going to set up four separate banks of engines, just to basically copy this design into the four corners of this room down here. And this is going to be my engine room. And you can see that the red pipe wire comes down to these gates. So whenever these gates receive a red pipe wire signal, they send a redstone signal to the combustion engine telling it to turn on. And that's how all these are going to work. And each one of these banks is going to have a different color of wire. So this one's blue, this one's yellow, and this one over here is going to be green. But in order to work with those other colors of pipe wire, what I had to do is make some higher tier gates, because the basic gates will only work with red pipe wire. If we look at the different gates, we can see that the basic gate only works with red. Then you have to go to iron for blue. It'll also work with red, of course. Then you have to go to gold to be able to work with green. And quartz also works with green. I don't know what the difference is between gold and quartz. If there actually is any other differences other than the fact that, material-wise. And then the top tier is diamonds and emeralds are able to work with yellow signals. There is probably some sort of difference. Maybe one of you guys can let me know what that is in detail. Maybe I will be able to use that in part of my builds later. So, yeah, I want to show you this before I covered it up. So, basically, these gates up here are going to look for a redstone signal. If there's redstone signal is off, then it's going to go ahead and send the green pipe wire signal, right? And this final diamond one is also going to, I really didn't need all the extra whirlies or the extra controls, but this one's just going to send a yellow pipe wire when there's no redstone signal. So in order to get those their redstone signal, cover them up with a facade on that side of those pipes, and then go ahead and put a lever on them. If we look over here, we can see that the yellow and the green are on right now. And if I turn that one off, it's turning off the green pipe wire. And if I turn this one off, it should turn off the yellow pipe wire. Right. And then if I turn this one on, or well, technically if I turn it, actually the down is on, which is kind of weird with the switches, which is why I kind of like have it backwards. Because I wanted it to be up is on for the engines and down is off. So, yeah, anyway, and then when that one's up, the red pipe wire's on. Okay, so you get the idea, hopefully. And then what is this making? Redstone chipsets? Yeah, okay, I don't need any more redstone chipsets. Just turned it on for demonstration purposes. So, yeah, eventually that's going to, I'm going to facade all of this pipe over so that you won't see it in the end. And I'm going to stick with the basic stone for the floor and ceiling in this room and probably do similar down here. Basic stone for the floor and ceiling. I'm going to have some pillars in here and make this look like it's actually supported instead of just a big open area. This is also going to be where my oil storage and processing is going to eventually be. So one other thing I need to get to in the tech line of stuff over here, now that the power is explained, power systems are explained. Next episode, that should be all put together. I'm not going to work on it on camera. But I think you get the idea. Basically, all the other engine setups are going to be the same. So I need to do some enabling. That's what the world enables. This right here is going to be super important to me to get done, because I need to get titanium in order to make steel. And I wanted to show you the process of getting titanium. It's not too difficult once you've done it, but like if you've never done it before, it might be a little confusing the first time. So I got a bunch of rutile. Remember, I got rutile from the Nether. And I processed that somewhere down here. I had things set up. There it is. Furnace set up that was burning or was melting down all of my rutile, or all my nether ores, actually. Is it rutile in here? Yeah, right there, rutile. So I got 40 of it. I actually got 20 nether ores. When you cook it in a regular furnace, it gives you 2 regular ores, and then that's going to go in here. Molten tin. Why do I have molten tin in there? No idea. But let's start pumping. I've changed this over to a gate, so that now I don't have a big bulky wooden engine there. But let's start pumping that tin out of there, because I don't need the tin. I do need the wrench. Switch that around so it starts pulling out. All right. And go ahead and, actually, I think this can hold all 40 at once. Yes, it can. There we go. Get that melted down. Put them all in at once, because it's the same amount of lava. no matter how many items you have in there. So yeah, that's gonna pump out the tin, and in a little bit, in just a short period of time, I should start having some rutile meltdown, which is gonna give me some kind of titanium. But it's not gonna be the titanium that I want. It's gonna be this impure titanium, blocks of impure titanium. In order to make steel, I need to make a blast furnace. This guy right here, blast furnace, but it needs purified titanium. Well, to get purified titanium, I need to mix, and let's back through this if we can, maybe somewhere here. I don't know if it's going to even show it to me. Molten titanium. Oh, what if I say molten titanium? Is there another? No. Go over here. Ah, here we go. Smeltery alloying. So in order to get pure titanium, molten titanium, I need to mix magnesium with impure molten titanium. So how do you get magnesium, you're probably asking. Well, that's not too crazy difficult. We're needing to get some of that. I don't know if you remember a while back I said, hey, I'm going to need limestone at some point. I should have been heating this thing up. Let's turn that on. I'm out of lava in it, but it doesn't need that lava. That's only just like if I wanted to keep it warmed up, I should have had it warmed up for this. But I can just go ahead and grab some. Actually, let's get a stack of coal coke and toss that in there. And that's going to take a little bit to heat up. So I'm going to put some limestone in there. Right? Once that melts down into, I think it's called quick lime. You may notice over here, I don't know if I've mentioned these yet or not, but I put these upgrades in here. I probably could make some more upgrades or improve these upgrades, but I'm not going to worry about that right now. What I'm think I'm going to do is just let this heat up. It's going to have to get to 825. That's going to take a little while. And then I'm going to get this ready over here real quick, and then we'll wait, and then I'll cut until that gets hot enough to start melting stuff. So I want a couple more vats. I want three more vats. Because what I can do is I can improve the size of this. Whoops, I accidentally put a vat in a vat. There we go. Now I have a big vat. And you may have already noticed that I've got these levers set up with some gate controls and some wooden fluid pipes. So I've turned off of the auto eject on this because I don't want things going in here right now. And I want to be able to get things out relatively quick. The wooden gate extracts much faster than this thing auto ejects. So, and I'm also going to need some water in here. So I've already got some fluid tank, some water, and I can go ahead. I can actually start pumping that in now. There's no big reason to wait. So this thing will actually hold 30,000 millibuckets, which is 30 buckets of two separate types of fluid. That's not its total max capacity. That's its max capacity for each input. So it's going to take in all 16 buckets, and then I'm going to get another, in fact, I already have it ready to go, another fluid tank, and put that in there. I'm going to get this thing full of water, and that's only going to fill up the one. See how it says at the top where there's one input and input two is empty and output is empty? So I'm just going to wait for this to heat up, and I'll be back in a minute and we'll see how this works. Well, that sure does take a long time to heat up, so I've decided to craft myself a heating upgrade. Also increased the speed upgrade one of the speed upgrades that was in there. So I already made the basic upgrade that is right here. It's just two heating coils and a piece of iron, and I need the tier 2 one, which is going to be two more heating coils and three pieces of aluminum. So two more heating coils and one, two, three pieces of aluminum. And I believe I'm not going to quite be able to make the third tier one yet, the advanced. Actually, maybe I could. Maybe I could do that one. Because that one's just aluminum and iron. And we can get some more aluminum. And I should have some iron over here there we go. And let me go ahead and come on. You can do it. I think it was aluminum here and there, and then iron around. Yeah, there we go. So I got a tier 3 heating upgrade. So it must be the tier 4 one, ultimate heating upgrade, that requires titanium. Okay. I'm not able to do that yet, because that's the whole point of what I'm trying to do here, is make the titanium. Well, there we go. That should allow it to go ahead and start heating up much faster. Yes, you can see that it's heating up much faster now. And because I've got the upgraded hyperkinesis upgrade in there, and it's going to work pretty quick. You can see it's making the quick lime. I want to go ahead and take that quick lime and pump that into my vat that already has water in it. And that's going to go into input 2. And as soon as it gets enough quick lime in there, it's going to go ahead and create. It should start making some little smoke particles over top of it whenever it gets enough material to start working. I want to get some more quick lime, or more lime, because I want to make a bunch of this. Since I'm using materials to fire this up and keep it hot, I might as well make a bunch of it while I got it going. There we go. And there we're getting some particles. And we can see inside there that we got our first piece of magnesium. Now I went ahead and crafted a block of that, made a block using the export thing there, of the impure titanium. And the reason I needed to get one of those is because it's actually used in crafting the rutile seed. So I'm going to need to do, probably I'll do that off camera, but there's a recipe. It's, it's 4 runes, a block of impure titanium and some strong essence. But I need to get that one in order to move forward in the what the world is made from. I think that's what it's called. What the world's built from, sorry. That one right there, I still need to get the rutile seed. I managed to get fragmented seed and spidey seeds. I can actually turn those in now. Claim that. Because I don't need either of those other essences. I definitely could use the strong essence more. I mean, I don't need the essence of spider or the other ones. Got plenty of those already. And I need to still make the speed seed, which is not, I don't think that one's too hard. I'm not sure why I didn't already make it. Splash potion swiftness. Because I haven't bothered to make any potions. That's probably why. So yeah, I got that. Just set that aside. Actually, I'll put it in here for now, and I'll do that off camera. So now that I'm getting some magnesium in here, I'm up to 6. Excellent. Keep feeding this thing more limestone. And so keep making quick lime and pumping it into there. Excellent. Now I can take that magnesium and drop it into my smeltery, where I've already got a whole bunch of impure molten titanium. And as soon as it mixes with this magnesium that I'm about to melt into there, it should purify it, or some of it anyway. Presumably 6 ingots worth. Yes, there we go. Molten titanium, 6 ingots. Okay, but I need a block, so I gotta wait for about 3 more. Yeah, as soon as another one comes up here and I can get a block. I almost kind of wish I had a manual version of this back here. Maybe I should put a manual version of this on the side just for the occasional time that I'll need to manually get a block out of there. Because if I go pumping out the titanium, then I'm liable to get some of the impure titanium in the pipe. Well, it probably isn't too big of a deal. Well, anyway, I'll do that. I can always melt it back down. because I want to get that impure titanium out of there. Because I think I've even got, yes, there's the recipe set up for the, actually I'm going to need more than a block, I think. I'm going to need 2 blocks of impure titanium. Or 2 blocks of titanium, not the impure stuff. Turn that back off. How many more magnesium do I got now? Alright, I want to take a quick cut until I've got 2 full blocks of titanium, regular stuff. Okay, there's my second block of titanium. Just got pulled and should be over here as we speak. Yep, there we go. 2 blocks of titanium. So, back over here, I throw the titanium onto there and start hitting it with the hammer. Left clicks. Don't hold it down. I think it takes like 50 clicks or something like that. It's a lot. Click, click, click. Come on. Any day now. Maybe it's more than 50 clicks. It's a lot of clicks. There it is. And pull it off, and I've got my 8 sheets of titanium. Excellent. So with that, I can go ahead and make the first bits. Seriously? Did this recipe change? Blast furnace. Titanium sheets. Oh, that's right. These are construction blocks, and these are infernal bricks, which are made by somewhere in here. Infernal blocks, which are nether bricks and soul sand. Forgot about that. Nether bricks and soul sand. Should both of those be in my nether stuff? Yep, I don't have much soul sand, but I don't think I need too many nether of these bricks. So do that, get. So I need 8 of them. Oh, I need one more bit of soul sand, but I can make soul sand over here somewhere. In there, I think. Oh, S-O-U-L, soul sand. Seriously? There it is. Need some more soul sand. And let's see, I needed just the one more bit, I think. Then I believe it's like this. No, is it? Yeah, there we go. Just converts like that and like that. And there we go. Blast furnace bricks. I need about twice that much. Which is why I got the second bit of titanium, block of titanium. Okay, downstairs here, I need to decide where I'm going to set up my blast furnace to make steel production. No, probably not that side. Probably over here somewhere. Planning on having another set of those guys here. So that'd be 1, 2, 3. And then if I skipped one, nope, that's too close to the door. So I could put it like just on this side of this tank. So the question is, do I put it centered up beside the tank, leave a little space, plan on having some other big tanks over there? Good question. Okay, well, you know what probably would help if I turn my, yeah, that helps, because I'm going to be having like some supports go right along here. So don't want to interrupt that. So I'm actually going to come down this way a little bit and then go 1, 2, 3, and then put it right about here. Yeah, why not? Give it a little space around it. I don't probably need to give it much space. Now this one is, instead of it being a 3x3x3, it's 4 tall, but it's still hollow in the middle. Which means I'm probably going to have 2 bricks left over. There we go. And now I have a blast furnace. Excellent. Next thing to do would be to get some fuel for it. And get some coal coke out of all of these. I need to finish setting up the automation on these so that it actually just continuously produces coal coke for me. Probably do that off camera and then just show you what I've done to make that work. But let's get some more coal coke, because what I want to do for the fuel is I actually want to turn these into blocks. There we go. Blocks of coal coke. And then I'm going to take and get a stack of iron. Head back down there real quick. Get that started. And then now that I've got some steel started, turn these back off. Turn them lines off. Now that I got some steel started. What was that? Aluminum. Okay. I will be able to upgrade my pick between episodes and go ahead and go do some mining of some higher tier stuff and get ready for having the best metal of the game. Be able to use that to finalize my pick and possibly upgrade my cleaver finally, because I'll probably have something that's better than cactus at that point. Which I'm pretty dang sure it'd be better than cactus. Put this stuff back away. Culture. Okay. Then, quick things I want to talk about before I get into a little bit of magic this episode. Made this thing, gate copier. Really, and not a hard recipe. It's just a redstone chipset and a wrench to give you a gate copier, and that's going to be helpful because if I down there on those gates for all those engines, they're going to have the same thing from one to the next. So all I got to do is set one, you know, and then right click it. Gate information cleared. Okay, maybe. Well, I probably actually have to click on a gate. But anyway, this is going to allow me to copy these settings from one gate to another and make it a little bit quicker to set that up later when I'm working on it. The other thing I really wanted to talk about that I hadn't mentioned that I did between episodes is I've upgraded my crossbow. I've also upgraded my alumite hammer with redstone, lots of redstone. So this thing breaks rock much better. I've also added silk touch to the hammer. So that's how I've managed to get all of that smooth rock up there that's without having to cook it. So now whenever I dig around in the ground or open areas up, then I'm getting that rock instead of making more cobblestone for myself. Upgraded that too, because I keep getting more and more cracked sand. Maybe someday I will find a good way to just automatically turn all that into regular sand. But not today. So yeah, upgraded those. Obviously this has moss on it, so it repairs a little bit over time, but it's kind of slow, so I might put moss 2 on it. But before I can do that, well, I've got one modifier remaining on there, so I could probably go ahead and do that. My cactus crossbow, I've put a bunch of redstone on it, and I've gotten the draw speed down to 1 second, and it still has the moss upgrade. Really, the moss 1 upgrade is not too bad, because this thing doesn't have a lot of durability to begin with. But you can see, fires much faster. But I'm not going to be happy until it fires faster yet. So there is one more thing I can do to upgrade it. If I go ahead and get some more redstone first, get some 5 redstone blocks and 5 redstone. 5. But before I can utilize that, I need a block of gold. and a diamond. Because what I can do, hopefully I can do it in this pack. I haven't tested this. I really hope this works. If I put a block of diamond and gold there. Yes, it does work. I'm going to get another modifier. Woohoo! Another modifier is going to allow me to speed this baby up. Another 50 redstone worth. Which brings it to 0.65 second draw speed. Not bad. So yeah, watch out, bad guys. I've got a machine gun. So yeah, I wanted to explain that I had upgraded those off camera. And now I think it's time to get in some magic. I'm going to clear my inventory up and I'll be back in a moment. Alright folks, I'm back and I think I'm ready to get some of this Botania stuff done. I know I said something about doing some witchery soon, but this needs to be taken care of before I can really move into that. So you may remember that I made the agglomeration plate not that long ago. I went ahead and set that up in right underneath this agglomeration. Actually, go ahead and break it, show you that that is actually a piece of living rock in the center. And then lapis blocks and more living rock. To make this work, though, I'm going to need something called a spark. For that, you're going to need some blaze powder, some gold nuggets, and some mana petals. So let's get some mana petals. This one's fullest, I think. Myself some mana petals. They need to be the same color, but they can be any color. But they both got to be the same color. And I am going to make 6, although I think I only need 2 for today. So, yeah, we'll use that one. Why not? And I'm going to come over here and put one right on top of the agglomeration plate. To use the agglomeration plate, you need a mana diamond, a mana pearl, and a mana steel. And you probably, if you have one of these magnetization rings, you want to take it off for this. We need one of those. And then you want to throw these right on there. Oh, dang it. Get on there. And then move away. There we go. And you can see that the spark transfers power much, much faster than the mana spreader would. It's going to use up a half a pool of mana in order to craft 1 Terra Steel. Let's get that Terra Steel made. Day now. There it goes. Pick up my Terra Steel. And that should complete this right here. It's not out of this world. It's not out of this world. That's going to give me 2 more Terra Steel ingots. That's good, because I'm going to need those here in a second. And something else I need to make is these mana pylons. So if I make some mana pylons, actually I need 2 of them. Couple more mana steel. That's a mana diamond in the middle, and then you get 2 pylons. I think that's gonna, is that gonna complete this? No, I actually have to make the enchanting table. We'll go ahead and make that a little bit. But now that I have those, I can use those to craft with 1 of my Terra Steel 2 Natura pylons. So next up, I'm gonna actually need to get 2 maniples. I gotta make the diluted ones and then go ahead and toss them back into maniple. Gives me the regular ones. And those are gonna go right there and right there. Pretty sure. Hopefully I got those positioned correctly. And before I put the Natura pylons on top of those, I wanna fill them with some mana. Now remember, I got a bunch of mana tablets back, you know, full mana tablets for some quest rewards. So I can go ahead and throw. Actually, I kind of wanted that one. That one's had some. Okay. Well, might as well use that one now. And those are going to fill up those maniples for me. While those are filling up, I might as well make the other couple parts that I need. I need 3 pieces of glimmering living wood, which is just a regular living wood with pieces of glowstone. So I need 3 of those. And you put 1 of those in each side and top. Now the bottom center needs to be a, take that other piece of Terra Steel that I got from the quest, needs to be the Elven Gateway Core. So there we go, that goes in the center bottom. These ones are done. Where did the, oh. Empty that one, please. Let me get that emptied into there. Then once that those pools are full, I can go ahead and put a Natura pylon on there. I forgot to make one thing. So let me wait for this because I don't want it to despawn. Because it will despawn after a while. I want to make sure it empties it all out. I think it's all empty. And then get that last little bit filled up from this final tablet. I'll have to fill these up back later when I have a more substantial supply of mana. But right now, I want to keep this for crafting stuff, and that's the one I will keep in my inventory to supply mana to my armor. Okay, and then I can put the other pylon on here, like so. One other thing that I want to do before I get any further with this is make a certain thing, and I need to, didn't bring one in with me. Cactus, need some cactus. I think it's cactus. In here? Yeah, that'll give me some slime balls. Take and make a sticky piston. One slime ball and one piston makes me sticky piston, and give me a lever. Because what this will allow me to do is shut the gate off relatively easy when I'm not wanting to use it. Put that there. So there we go. When I'm done using it now, I can just toggle that lever. It'll pull that block out of position and break the gate. But now I'm ready to activate it, I believe. If I've made everything, if I put everything in the right place, it should turn on. All I need to do is smack it with the wand of forest. There we go. And it looks like I did it right. It's turned on. And I should have brought my lexicon out there. Let me grab a lexicon. Lexicon Batania. And I chuck this into the gate, and it's going to give me some extra. Did it go? Chuck that into the gate, and it should come back with some extra knowledge. So now you see that that is got the Elven Guard information in there. Back up, there's all the Elven stuff. But the thing is, the main thing that I need this for is I need it to... Well, one of the things I need is I need to throw some Living Rock in there. Because that's going to give me my Skystone blocks that I've been waiting. That's what's going to be... I'm going to use for that. The roof up there. At this point, I think I can go ahead and put this back on. And that's going to allow pull things to me. The other thing I want to be able to, other things I want to throw through there is I want to throw some magic wood. Yeah, the living wood. And that's going to give me back the dream wood, so I'll be able to make some better mana spreaders with that. And some stuff. Then the next other thing I need to send through there is some of these guys, some mana pearls. That should give me back some pixie dust. Hopefully I didn't throw it through there too soon. Still give me back dreamwood. There comes the pixie dust. And then finally, I need some diamonds. Actually, I need quite a few mana diamonds. I don't think I have any more ready to go. No, I do not. I'm going to have to go grab some diamonds, turn them into mana diamonds, throw them through there, and that's going to give me the Dragonstone things. Just get a bunch of those. And that is the item that I really needed before I can get too far into witchery. Toss those in there, make some more off camera, make a bunch more of this stuff off camera too. But now I'll just throw some mana diamonds in there. It should start give me those back. And as long as you don't leave this running like all the time, I mean, you can if you have the supply of mana, but I really don't have that kind of mana supply. I just have my daylilies over, or my day blooms over there and nightshades, which are a kind of a trickle of mana, really. So I don't want to leave this on when I'm not using it. I mean, it does take a little bit extra power to open it, but if I just left it running when I wasn't using it, it would probably take a lot more power than if I just turn it on only when I need to throw something in there. And, you know, I can make resources in mass instead of having to... So there we go. Just boop, and now it's disassembled. And flip that switch again. It's ready to go next time I need it. And it's not burning up any mana while I'm not using it. Let me go sleep off this daytime. Then there's one more thing I wanted to show you before we leave off, because that's going to have to do with some things I'm going to do between episodes. So I don't know if you've noticed over there, there's no more hill, there's no more mob spawner. This is all flat over here. And I'm actually going to flatten some more out. This is two chunks wide. I'm actually going to go out to three chunks, and I'm going to make this a big 3x3 chunk area over here that I think I'm going to turn into a village. And I believe that over here on this 1x3 chunk area, I'm going to actually turn that into a pasture farm where we're going to have some farm some animals. And, you know, you shouldn't mess with me, Mr. Knight. I've got a machine gun. So, yeah, I just wanted to show you that I'm working out here, and next episode there'll probably be something to see out here. Something, I'll give a little bit of a start on a village out there. Because now that I have the materials, I should go ahead and make my villager eggs and get that started. So, guys, I hope you enjoyed this episode as much as I enjoyed making it. I apologize if you were expecting to see some witchery in this episode. I didn't get to it, but I do promise to do some witchery next episode. You can smack me around if I don't. So, hey, well, be sure to leave a like, comment, thumbs up, all that fun stuff, and I will catch you later.